While the calendar may say your true age, do you know just how old you are biologically? It could actually be a lot older.
Yeah, and that has to do with how you live your life and how much stress you have. And here to talk about it is biotechnologist Greg Macpherson. Hey, Greg, good to talk to you today.
Likewise. Good morning from New Zealand.
Wow. I didn't know that's where you were. Wow. All the way around the world. So tell us, Greg, what is the difference between our biological age and our chronological age?
All right. So we all know our chronological age. That's the day we were born and how many times we're fortunate enough to, I guess, circulate around the sun. But a biological age is the age that our cells are acting. And those two numbers can be quite different. In fact, could be even decades apart. And it's all about how healthy we are. And when our cells have a biological age, which is younger, it just means that they are literally acting younger than our chronological age. And that's a good place to be.
And what does testing our DNA tell us about age?
Yeah, so I guess a lot of people think about DNA testing as about your ancestry or perhaps looking at what sort of disease risks you might have. But there's a test now for your DNA called epigenetic age or a methylation age, which sounds sciencey, but essentially there's a bit of a clock that you have on your DNA and it actually you can measure how old your cells are acting. And that's quite exciting because we can now then measure what we do and how it makes us healthier.
So there is your DNA, and their DNA can be damaged, right? So I'm wondering, can that actually be reversed?
Yeah, that's the beautiful thing about your biological age is that you can slow it down and reverse it. So things like things we know that are good and healthy for us, like exercise and diet, actually slow your biological age. And there's also supplements now, which also can help you do that. And there are people out there that perhaps have a chronological age of 60, but actually got a biological age of 30. And these are the people that are aging really well.
Wow. So there's something called zombie cells. This is pretty new to me. I'm sure it's not what I'm picturing in my mind when I think of zombie cells. But how do they affect us, especially right now, when it comes to the pandemic and people who have, you know, COVID-19?
Definitely. So zombie cells, they're called senescent cells is the science term, but they're actually like the living dead. They're cells that sit in our body and just don't do anything useful, and they're quite harmful because they secrete inflammatory gunk, etc., which affects the health of the cells around them. And we have them when we're young, but our body is really good at getting rid of them. But as we get older, they're not so effective at getting rid of them, so they become a burden. And it's why people think that we have more inflammation as we age. And the beautiful thing is that we can actually start to remove those by taking supplements like fisetin, which is an extract from strawberries, which helps the body identify them and then clear them out.
Can we just eat the strawberries instead of taking the supplement?
It certainly doesn't hurt to do that, but you need to take probably a couple of kilograms to actually get the effect. So there are supplements which actually concentrate it and make it more available for us.
And speaking of cleaning things out, we know how important sleep is. We've all been told you need your 8 hours or so. Tell us what goes on while we're asleep that is so important to cleaning out our system.
Yeah, when we sleep, it just actually gives our body time to actually do housekeeping and I guess renew and rejuvenate the cells that we have. And so, it's super important. And we know that if you miss out on sleep, you've got increased risk of things like diabetes, of other certain conditions as we age. So, you know, if you are challenged with sleeping, then it's actually something that's quite important for you to resolve. And obviously, people have different sleep needs. Some people have 4 to 6 hours, but if you can get as much as possible, then it's really good for your body and really good for your cells.
Yeah, I love talking about sleep, and I know
because
that
we're always sleep
deprived. We don't get a lot of it.
We
have to wake up really early in the morning. But not just sleep, we also talk a lot about diet. And I know that when I'm tired, my ability to eat more healthy is greatly decreased. So how do we, you know, get through the day, get through the week, and still enjoy the foods that we really love, but still stay healthy, especially if we are sleep deprived?
Yeah, it's a really, really good question because we're still learning exactly what our diet has the effect on our cells, if you will. But certainly what science seems to be coming through is that we actually need to be hungry a little bit of the time. And when we are hungry a little bit of the time, And that could be that you miss a breakfast, or it could be that you're just not snacking between meals. But it's really important you do that, because when you do, your body gets the chance to actually do that cellular housekeeping we talked about. And it's actually something which is quite often with the Western diet and just our lifestyles right now that we're not doing. And it's just so important to be able to do that and actually trigger the renewal cascades that our body actually normally does by just eating. Eating in a way which allows us to be not hungry and not full all the time.
Yeah, and I love the idea of appropriate snacking. I think sometimes I graze more than snacks.
Yes. so much to talk about. Diet, exercise, sleep, very important. And we want to thank you for pointing out how we can live our lives very healthily. Biotechnologist Greg Macpherson joining us from all the way from New Zealand this morning. We go all the way around the world for our experts. So we appreciate it. Thank you, Greg.
Next time we got to come to you. That's all I'm saying, right?
That'd be fantastic.